that they can share with you, this is only these 2 years. Anyhow, so another thing from my side, 2 minutes only. Basically, this is a small story. We do so many things which are neither true nor good nor beneficial, and without minding it whether it will be beneficial to anyone or whether it will do something good, whether it is true or not, we take the anything at the face value and we start to do, and we do, and ultimately what we end up with is that later on we find at the end when we have done that it was not required at all. Now the story is like this. There was a professor, a very good researcher and professor, and he had a very good student researcher. And one day, one of the childhood friend of the professor came rushing to the professor, and hurriedly he started saying, "The professor, professor, you know what I have heard about your this student, research scholar." The professor was very intelligent. He immediately just realized that he's come rushing and hurriedly he wants to say something about one of my very dear students, to whom I love very much, and he is very obedient, very intelligent as well. So he must not say something good about him. But if I will listen to him and what he will tell me, I will not take action on this, I will lose my friend. But if I listen to him and if I take action, I will lose my very good student, researcher. So how to come out of it? Immediately, he devised, he developed, he thought an idea. He said, "Okay, I will listen to you, whatever you want to say, but whenever I do anything, and that we should do, I'll do also, I have a three-tier filter test. I have a three-tier filter test. Whenever I do anything, at least one of the three components, one of the three tiers, it must qualify. If it does not qualify any of the three, I don't do. And this applies to you as well." The friend said, "Okay, any of the three parts I will qualify. So this is agreeable." Now the professor asked, "Now you tell me what you want to tell." He said, "I want to say something about your this student." Now professor said, "My question, the first component is truth. First component is truth. Are you sure that something that you are going to tell about this student, and you know I love him very much, is it true, 100% true?" The friend shrugged his shoulders. "No, I have heard it from someone else." Now the professor said, "Something which you are not sure about, whether it is true or not, and that you are going to share with me, so here you fail." The friend agreed. Now friend hurriedly asked, "What is the second component?" "Second component is good." The professor asked, "Something hurriedly which you have admitted is not true, you are going to say about this student, is something good about him?" The friend said, "No, rather the contrary." Then the professor said, "Something which is not true, something which is not good. When something is not good and it is not true, 100%, you are going to say about that student." The friend said, "Okay, I fail in the second component also. Now what is the third component?" Professor said, "The third component is, will it benefit anyone? So if I listen to you, I take action on it, will it do some benefit to you?" Friend said, "No." "Will it benefit me?" "No." "Will it benefit anyone?" He said, "No. When something which is not true, something which is not good, something which is not going to benefit any one of us, then why do anything?" So anyway, what I want to say was, some of the things we do, particularly gossip and all this, when it is not going to benefit any one of us, so we should avoid that. Now I am coming to the job that I've been given now. So Mr. Ravinder Henry spoke at length about the various issues which are related to the growth and economic development of the country, and he was little very blunt on saying that the service sector of the country is growing at a faster rate than the industry and this manufacturing sector. So we all know that there are three sectors of any economy: agriculture, the primary, and secondary, the manufacturing, and third, the service sector. Yes, of course, if India is a developing country, I don't know whether it is a developed country or developing country or fastly developing country or underdeveloped country. So different sectors are at different stages. But anyhow, so we need to keep pace with what is the most required aspect. Maybe in some of the sectors, we need service sector to grow faster. Some of the sectors, we need to, agriculture, we altogether cannot give up. We need to take care of the agriculture, that is the primary sector also. But some of the areas where we can excel in the manufacturing, we should take more care of the manufacturing sector as well. Yes, he is right to some extent that service sector, unnecessarily and undesired spheres, we should not unnecessarily let it grow. And then he also discussed that passion, which I also vouch for it. Passion is more important than doing anything, for doing anything. Yes, if you have passion for doing anything, you can do. If you want passion, then rather we should leave it. Yes, he was again a bit pessimistic that India doesn't produce any aircraft or any ship and all this. Yes, we are lagging behind, but one cannot do everything. We are far ahead than the various other countries of the world in many other things also. So that aspect also needs to be taken care of. But anyhow, he has his own views. But here I am reminded of one small story again. Basically, the opportunities, if properly analyzed, they can be wonderful fruit, bring wonderful fruits. But if once an opportunity goes, it is not gone forever. Sometimes the luck, chance or opportunity knocks again also. What we need to do is that we need to either struggle for it or try or see that the opportunity reoccurs. A small story. There was a honeybee. No? One time, the honeybee entered in a house. The lady of the house, she was preparing some pudding and mithe chawal, right? And this honeybee, this lady wanted to put some jaggery in the in this rice and rice pudding. And she opened this vessel and just forgot to put on in hurry the lid back. This honeybee smelled that some jaggery is there. It went into the jar and start enjoying the jaggery. And after some time, this lady, without noticing that honeybee is there in the jar, she put the lid back. When the enjoyment of the jaggery of the honeybee was over, it wanted to go out. But it could not because it was covered with the jar was covered with the lid. After a few days, now this honeybee thought that now this was in my luck, there is no chance for me to get out of it and enjoy my rest of the life. Let me make my home in the corner of this jar only and let me spend whole of my life here only. But after some days, this lady just noticed that there is a poor honey bee in the jar and it will die. So let me let her free. So she opened the jar, try to make the honeybee go out, but it did not because it had given up all its hopes. So never give up all hopes. Opportunity comes again also. So anyhow, so there are many other issues which have been discussed by Mr. Henry, but let me come to the first presentation by Dr. Girija Shankar. And she has discussed about the various policies and inflation of the country, particularly the fiscal and monetary policies. And then global scenario, some of the spheres, the India is having a very bright scenario. She has discussed about the interest rates and the RBI policies. And she has said that if India needs to achieve a 7% growth rate, then we need to make matching fiscal policy as well. And it is estimated that India's growth rate, economic growth rate, GDP will be 7% for the next 2-3 years. And whereas the world growth rate is 3.5, that is a matter to cheer. Because India's growth rate, 7%, is almost double than the world ratio. But we need to sustain it. How we need to sustain it, all of us need to contribute. How we can contribute? One thing is that we must all pay our taxes, levies, and all this, what the government needs, because only then government also can, you can say, continue with this. Now, she had a major concern about the emerging economies. Except India, all the other emerging economies, their scenario is not very bright, very, very fascinating. But this is, again, I would like to suggest that the countries who are not doing as they had expected to grow, they need to revise. Nothing is perpetual, because things change, circumstances change, and we need to replan, reorganize, rearrange. Because if I say I have to reach from Pune to Delhi, say Bombay, this very route, and that day there is a lot of rush, I'm in a hurry, so I need to make change. So change is the order of the day. We need to make change, appropriate change, so that we are able to reach, achieve our goal. She talked about GST as well. So I don't take much time on this. Energy and transport was also discussed by her. The second paper. In the second paper, Professor Priti Umesh Sharma, right? So the title is An Old Business Derivative with Transport Sources, a Way Towards Successful Economic Development, right? So she discussed about the sustainability. What basically sustainability is? Sustainability is that given, under the given given circumstances, how best we can do. It is not that I should do all the things myself, I should get everything for myself. So she discussed that banks play a very important role. Of course, banks play a very important role in the economic, for the financial needs of the country. Services she discussed are very banking services are availed by financial services, but particularly they are availed by very few people. About 40%, she said, that is the literacy rate about the financial services. Yes, we need to make some such, rather than opening up the more bank branches. Someone was arguing that we need more bank branches, but my opinion, my viewpoint is, rather than opening up more bank branches, what we need to do is that we need to make mobile banking. We need to educate people more to use more banking services, and also the banking people, banking employees, they need to be more cooperative and helpful and educative, so that more, and also more and more people come to the banks for availing of their services. And the third paper, this was about the Association of the Countries Development Social Corporate Social Responsibility and National Service Scheme. And there are many issues which she has discussed, is that NSS and company can go together for the development of the society. Yes, of course, it is right. If proper, she has developed her own model for the development of the country with the help of the NSS. And there she is right. And she has given the example of Tata, TCS, Asian Paints, that they have taken up some social responsibility issues like education, adopting of the village, eye care things, and the environment. Here, there are more things that we need to discuss here is, basically, our legislation is not that stringent as it is in US. Because the economic development should also take care of the economic, the physical environment. What we are doing is that most of the industry wherein we have many pollution acts, even if these pollution acts laws are followed hardly by these companies, I think they are doing their social responsibility better than otherwise. And also, the social responsibility toward the government, toward the employees, toward the various customers. If we are producing a product and we are it is superior quality, inferior quality, if it is not meeting the standards required, but we are writing that it is meeting these standards, but it is not. Or if we are overcharging because of the innocent of the people, there are cell companies charging 18 rupees per minute call, right? So they were overcharging, so they are not doing social responsibility. So anyhow, social responsibility by the corporate should be taken care of, right? She is saying that NSS, yes, NSS is being you can say taken care, and NSS being has been introduced, and NSS is being taking care of the various villages. They have adopted some villages there, they do some of the things which the government can do. So various types of works which otherwise are not possible, they are done by the volunteers of the NSS. Yes, I am in agreement with her that some of the issues which the corporates and NSS, they should take hand in hand, and they can do this. So with this, I have, you can say, completed brief summing up of the three papers that have been presented. So now, if you want to ask any question from me, you are welcome.